Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good. His love endures forever. Let the redeemed of the Lord tell their story. Those He redeemed from the hand of the foe. Those He gathered from the lands, from east and west, from north and south. Some wandered in desert wastelands, finding no way to a city where they could settle. They were hungry and thirsty, and their lives ebbed away. Then they cried out to the Lord in their trouble, and He delivered them from their distress. He led them by a straight way to a city where they could settle. Let them give thanks to the Lord for His unfailing love and His wonderful deeds for mankind. For He satisfies the thirsty and fills the hungry with good things. Let the one who is wise heed these things and ponder the loving deeds of the Lord.
Good morning and welcome to church today. It's lovely to see you all here. Haven't the mornings been great lately? I don't know about you, but yes, it's cold and my family don't like the cold. But if you do go sit outside in the freezing cold weather with your blanket and keep yourself nice and warm while you do it, I'm very loud today, Dixon. I mean, I don't need a microphone to be loud, but I'm very loud today, just putting that out there. If you do go sit outside, isn't it beautiful, crystal clear and still? It is cold, but it is still. You don't even see the clouds moving in the sky. It's these beautiful, beautiful blue skies. And the sun comes down on your face. You might get a little bit of sunburn and a little bit of frostbite all at the same time, but it is beautiful. And it's a lovely time to sit and to ponder and think about things. And when I have my mind wander, I tend to find myself singing little ditties or tunes in my head, the catchy ones, the lines that stick in your head. And this week I blame Bruce because he introduced me to a song which got stuck in my head this week, which went, well, the lines go, I won't sing it because it's a male song and it doesn't sound so great coming out my voice. And it goes, there is no one like my God, there is no one like our God. There is no one like our God. There is no one like our God. And I trust you, it's a very catchy tune. But there is the lines and it goes, no death, no life. Bruce can sing it. No, he won't do it. He's shy, but he can sing it because he knows the song I'm talking about. And it says, no height or depth can stand between us. No power on earth or all creation. No life or death can separate us from your love. And it's really catchy. So if you want to go look up a song, Lincoln Brewster, No One Like Our God, very catchy, gets stuck in your head. But that song I love because it speaks scripture into me. Because those lines, anyone know the Bible verse straight off the top of their head? Took me a little bit to remember it. Junior soldiers, people. Romans 8:38. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future or any powers, neither height nor depth nor anything else in creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that's in Christ Jesus our Lord. And how lovely it is to sit in the sun and to be reminded of God's love and that nothing can separate us. So thank you, Bruce, for that song. It's got my head. It led me to picking a song for us to sing this morning where the second verse says, what can separate us from your love? It's What a Beautiful Name, and I'd like to invite you to stand and to sing along with us this morning. Yep. You are the Word at the beginning, one with God the Lord Most High. Your hidden glory in creation, now revealed in you, our Christ. What a beautiful name. What a beautiful name it is, the name
King. What a beautiful name it is. Nothing compares to this. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus. You didn't want heaven without us. So Jesus, you brought heaven down. My sin was great, your love was greater. What could separate us now? What a wonderful name it is. What a wonderful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a wonderful name it is. And nothing compares to this. What a wonderful name it is. The name of Jesus. What a wonderful name it is. The name of Jesus. Death could not hold you. The veil tore before you. Your silence surpassed our sin and grave. The heavens are roaring, the praise of your glory. For you are raised to life again. You have no rival. You have no equal. Now and forever, God, you reign. Yours is the kingdom. Yours is the glory. Yours is the name above all names. What a powerful name it is. What a powerful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a powerful name it is, and nothing can stand against. What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a powerful name it is, the name of Jesus.
Would you like to take a seat? So I was thinking about the love of God. We always, and you think about the things that sit in your mind, that you'd stick with you for a long time. And I tell you that verse from Romans 8:38 because it stuck in my head for a long time because someone taught it to me as a child. Everyone taught me John 3:16, and it's not just a kid's verse, it's an adult's verse, it's an everybody verse, that for God so loved the world, he gave us his one and only son. The love, you can start, Jay. And I think to myself, as long as it's not unrequited love, it's unconditional, it'll always be there, but is it unrequited? Do you love him back? If you do, how are you going to show him that? Do you say it? Is it in your actions? Is it in the way you demonstrate it in your life? How do you give your life to him? Do you love him? This beautiful song, I read the history on it. It's at the top of the music. And Jeff Bullock wrote this song many years and years and years ago. I was very young at the time, just put that there. And he had been, it says in there that he was thinking through this and he just wanted to write a song of expression and appreciation. And it had been a long time in the making. And then I just One day he was walking around Castle Hill Towers shopping mall, if you've been there. At the time it's very small, but now it's a very big shopping centre, so I don't know how he had any peace or thoughtful mind to it, but he came home and it just came. And there's a line in there that says, it's about the finest whispers of how God talks to him. And there you go. Let me hear your finest whispers. He said he heard that line from somebody he knew with cerebral palsy, who said that that's how he hears God, through the finest whispers as they gently call my name. I think it's beautiful words, don't you?
Savior, my Lord and friend, I love you, Lord, and
your eyes and to sit in the still with the Lord today. See, Father God, you loved us before we were here, and you loved us before we surrendered our lives to you. You gave up your Son before we were even born, Lord. And you gave him up, so we know that you're going to give us every good gift in life. We can't contain your love. It is so huge. And Lord, I love you back. And just let me say how much I love you. And use me to love others, Lord, the way that you love me. And I pray these things in your precious name. Amen.
Thank you, Cassie. Beautiful time to start our worship this morning, wasn't it? I don't know if you're like me, there's nothing like a good cry through a song, you see? when the Lord just touches you. I pray that the Lord will take great joy in what he hears from our worship this morning, as the Lord heard you sing this morning and reached out to him this morning. And I pray that for the next little while we have our time of worship, that the Lord is going to drop something in your heart today. He's going to drop just what you need today. You need an extra measure of strength today. Perhaps of wisdom. Perhaps of understanding. Perhaps the Lord just wants you to come to a greater depth of trust in him than he has the details of your life right now. There's a couple of people I'm going to mention that are having a struggle at the moment, and one of those people is Jerry Zedris, and Jerry is not well right now, and we've been in touch with Jerry and the family. And Jerry has just asked and thanked the Corps and all the friends and family for so much care and prayer. But right now he's just asked us if we would respect his privacy so that just family, his sons are coming, and these are really precious days for the family. And so we said to Jerry that we mention it today. We can just respect his privacy and keep it to just family at this time. The other person is Albie. Albie's back in hospital. And so that's really hard for the family, and he went in for some general tests and they found that they needed to give him some more antibiotics, so he's back in hospital. And again, we just want to love Albie and Olive through this time, and Joe and the kids. And so we just ask that we be respectful of giving them their space. COVID. 2 visitors a day, and I can only be the same 2 visitors every day. It's very difficult, very difficult. But we can pray, can't we? We can uphold our people in prayer. We can uphold family in prayer. There are other people in the Corps going through some really difficult times right now. So I'm just going to pray, and I'd invite you to bow your heads with me and pray with me. Father God, we come to you just now in these sacred moments. We've sung those beautiful songs, we love you, Lord. Just let me say how much I love you, Lord. And we come before you just now. Every one of us comes before you, Lord, with our heads bowed. And we just lay at your feet our concerns today. We lay Jerry and the family at your feet. We lay Albie and his family at your feet. And there are unspoken things happening for people in our Corps today. And for those people that know about them, lay them at the feet of Jesus just now, I pray. Lay them at the feet of the cross. Lord, we know that you are a God of unimaginable miracles. You are a God of great peace. You are a God who has all of our details, all in your mind, and your love is so wide and vast and high and low, it's unfathomable for us. But because we know that, because we've read these promises in your word, we bring our people to your feet. And we just do that now. Because we know you are a God who answers prayer. You are faithful. You never leave us. No matter how difficult the road, you are always there. And so I pray in the name of Jesus for all of our needs today. Because we can have faith in a God who hears and answers prayer. I pray this in the name of Jesus. Amen. And amen. Well, thanks for coming today. I really thought we might be sitting in a little circle and it'd be like a cottage church, perhaps. It's a very significant day in the life of our country. And praise the Lord, the band is out. in the community today. At 8:30 this morning, they were at Woden for a 8:30 dawn service. That was great, wasn't it? And at 10:30, they will be marching around the grounds of Isabella Gardens. They're having their own ANZAC parade there. And the band is helping out with that. And so are the Timbrels. The Timbrels will be on as well. So it's good to be out in the community on a day like this. And I'm back from holidays. I've had a lovely holiday. I gained myself another daughter-in-law. Every time I go on holidays this year, I'm getting a daughter-in-law. Isn't that lovely? So good. Oh, the boys and days of just boys are over. Hallelujah. So good. So good. Well, for almost 120 years, the Salvation Army has supported Australian soldiers on base, in the field on exercises, and whilst on deployment, in places where our servicemen and women are struggling with separation from family and friends, loss, hardship, and even death. The representatives of the Red Shield Defence Services stand alongside all these people. As a reminder, as we remember today those that paid the ultimate price for our freedom, may our prayer be that God will open doors, soften hearts, and build his kingdom under the ministry of Salvation Army chaplains of the Red Shield Defence Services. We have some of our own people in the Corps here who are currently serving. Emma Hughes and her husband Scott, Caleb Gallagher, Sibby, son of Major Christine G, and Adam, son of Karen and Graham Ross. And there's possibly others you might like to remind me of after. But these people are serving, and we think of them today. We're going to sing just a few verses of a beautiful hymn, Abide With Me. It will take us to a place in our minds. On an ANZAC day, we will have heard this on a television broadcast, or at the dawn service we might have sung it this morning. So I thought it might be helpful as we just have a bit of a segment about ANZAC day today. And I invite you to sing these three verses.
The darkness.
with me.
I'd like to share a prayer with you this morning, written by our very own Major Brett Gallagher, Chief Commissioner of Defence, Red Shield Defence Services. Let's pray. Loving Father, today we remember the sacrifices of the original ANZACs and countless others in times of war and peace. We recognise before you the courage, determination and commitment of those who fought for our country, seeking justice and peace for all. We pray for those who have survived conflict, especially those who carry the scars of war in their minds and bodies. Be with them, strengthen them. We remember those, mainly women and children, who suffered and continue to suffer just because they happen to be in a conflict zone. May they know your overwhelming peace. Be with the brokenhearted, the spouses, parents, families and friends who endure the grief of knowing their loved ones will never return. Bring them comfort, we pray. We grieve for those who have been so destroyed by what they have experienced in service for their country that they have found no other option but to end their lives rather than continue to struggle with the deep pain they carried. Be with those who loved them, those left behind, shattered by their death. May they, through your Holy Spirit, know your grace, peace and comfort. We also pray for those who struggle with their service, be that in the past or in the present. Be with them today. Give us the strength and assurance that we can walk alongside those who are struggling and offer them reassurance and hope in our actions and words. May we, in our families, churches and communities, strive to practice reconciliation, understanding and peace each day to bring about the transformation of our world. May we continue to build a nation where our differences are embraced as strengths, where our workplaces are free from harassment and discrimination, and where we resolve to seek the well-being of all peoples who make this land their own. May your grace enable us this day to dedicate ourselves to the cause of justice, freedom and peace, and give us the wisdom and strength to build a better world. We pray this in and through your Son, Jesus. Amen and amen. I've asked you to just cast your eyes to the screen for the ode, the last post, a moment's silence, and the rest.
They shall not grow old as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them. Thank you.
lest we forget. Please take your seats.
Greater love has no man than he lay down his life for his friends. That's the verse that's been on my heart this week as I thought about the fact that it's Sunday and it's ANZAC Day and we're in the house of the Lord. And what does the Lord want us to know about today? So I'm going to read to you from John 15. First part of John 15 is all about the vine and the branches. But we're going to take it up this morning from verse 9. And it's the words of Jesus. And I'm reading from the Passion Translation today.
I love each of you with the same love that the Father loves me. You must continually let my love nourish your hearts. If you keep my commands, you will live in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commands. For I continually live, nourished and empowered by his love. My purpose for telling you these things is so that the joy that I experience will fill your hearts with overflowing gladness. So this is my command. Love each other deeply as much as I have loved you. For the greatest love of all is a love that sacrifices all. And this great love is demonstrated when a person sacrifices his love for his friends. You show that you are my intimate friends when you obey all that I command you. I have never called you servants because a master doesn't confide in his servants, and servants don't always understand what the master is doing. But I call you my most intimate friends, for I reveal to you everything that I've heard from my Father. You didn't choose me, but I've chosen and commissioned you to go into the world to bear fruit, and your fruit will last, because whatever you ask my Father for my sake, he will give it to you. So this is my parting command. Love one another deeply. Love one another deeply.
It's a soldier story, and I just want to give a little warning. There's some soldier talk in this soldier story, okay? It's not blatant bad words, but there's one bad word I'm going to use, okay? That will give you the story. William McKenzie. If you've heard of William McKenzie, Fighting Mac.
Oh, yes.
Yes. Don't steal my thunder. Don't steal my thunder. Now, if you've heard this story before, I want you to listen to it with fresh ears today. The Lord might just have something fresh to show you, to tell you out of the story. I've read it a number of times now. I know a tour guide from the War Memorial, and I said to him, can you give me a really good salvo ANZAC war story? And he said, Fighting Mac. So here we go. William McKenzie was a Salvation Army officer and military chaplain born on the 20th December 1869 in Biggar, Lancashire, Scotland. He was the eldest of seven sons. God bless his mother. And his dad's name was Donald, and his mum's name was Agnes. He claimed to have been brought up on porridge and plenty of those Scottish lickens. I think that means smacks on the bottom. His parents were strict Presbyterians. In 1884, the family migrated to Queensland. His father purchased a sugarcane farm near Bundaberg. and he prospered employing all of his sons. Mackenzie loved the outdoor life and worked as a jackaroo on a dairy farm. In 1887, he attended a Salvation Army meeting and found the practical Christianity on display much to his liking. And in 1889, following study at the training college in Melbourne, Mackenzie became a commissioned officer. His first posting was to Newcastle, New South Wales. A tough place, he said. He described it as this tough place. The Salvation Creed meant giving up drink, tobacco, and much else, and facing scorn. It meant living with the lowest and the worst. It meant fighting with the devil himself for the souls of men. Mackenzie said, "Here's the true religion for a fighting man." Mackenzie was posted throughout Australia, and he married a beautiful Aussie girl by the name of Annie, a fellow Salvationist from downtown Horsham. In 1914, he was an Australian delegate for the World Congress of the Salvation Army in London. On the outbreak of war, Mackenzie applied for chaplaincy immediately and was selected. He joined the Australian Imperial Force on the 25th of September 1914, was attached to the 4th Battalion, and sailed on the 20th of October. Mackenzie soon made his presence felt on the transport. He was a big man with a big voice. He conducted the usual church parades, but also organised concerts and sports. Unlike many chaplains, he participated in the men's recreation, taking particular delight in the boxing contests. His long reach, jarring uppercuts, and dangerous hard hooks left the best boxers dazed. His earliest nicknames were Holy Joe, Salvation Joe, then Padre Mac. But he was soon to become famous as Fighting Mac. Mackenzie was one of the first chaplains ashore at Gallipoli. He lumped stretchers and carried water for months on end, as well as tending the wounded and burying the dead. Observing the water carriers had difficulties on part of the track, he spent most of the night cutting out a series of steps. Mackenzie enjoyed the company of all types of Australians, and with a relaxed manner and broad sense of humour, encouraged men to talk freely with him. Many other chaplains seemed comparatively aloof and rigid in their views. Warning, here it comes. One soldier remarked, "I'm not religious, but your damned religion will do me every damn time." Sounds like he was a really good bloke. This Fighting Mac soon became renowned as a soldier as well as a chaplain. Reports abound that he led charges at Gallipoli, often armed only with a shovel. In France and Belgium, he continued to live in the front line with the troops. With the men, he endured that terrible 1916-17 winter at the Somme and tried to help with coffee stalls and other comforts. By this time, Mackenzie had become famous both in the AIF and at home. He lost 5 stone. That's 32 kilos at Gallipoli. but not his enthusiasm, and certainly not his powerful singing voice. He was forever writing songs. One Goodbye Cairo became the battalion's rallying cry. Living late 1917, Mackenzie was released from active service. His health shattered, not surprising from a man of 48. He had been awarded the Military Cross in June 1960 for distinguished service in the field. And it was rumoured that he had three times been recommended for the Victorian Cross. He was farewelled officially from the battalion, a most unusual gesture. After the war's end, Mackenzie remained famous and much in demand. He resumed Salvation Army work in several states until 1926. He took charge of the Salvationist work in North China. He spent more than 3 years in China and lost his heart to the country. Again, practical Christianity dominated his approach during an appalling 4-year drought with millions dying of starvation. Mackenzie returned to Australia with some reluctance in 1930. On March 1, 1939, Mackenzie retired from active work and was farewelled quietly in accordance with his wish. He died on the 26th of July 1947 in Sydney, survived by his wife, three sons and a daughter, a Salvationist medical missionary in Rhodesia. And Mackenzie was buried in Rookwood Cemetery. Greater love has no man than he laid down his life for his friends. There's a lot in that story, isn't there? There's a lot in that story about coming alongside people. There's a lot in the story about caring for people. There's a lot in that story about listening to people. I thank God for Fighting Mac, for William Mackenzie, who laid down his life for his mates. I say to us all today, life can be peaceful. Life can have sorrow. And the billows can roll. Today, the one who loves you the greatest, that demonstrated his love on the cross, who laid down his life for you, Jesus. Jesus did all that so that we can sing, "Whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to know, it is well with my soul." Amen. As we draw our worship to a close today, we're going to sing this beautiful, beautiful song, "It is well with my soul." I don't know if you're sitting near a peaceful river in life at the moment, going out in the cold and enjoying the stillness and the briskness of the air. Or maybe you're possibly not sleeping too well because there's so much on your mind. Or you've got loved ones that you're concerned about. There's things happening and it just feels like the billows are coming. Just pray this morning as we sing this song, as we reflect, greater love has no man than to lay down his life for his friends. Do you need to put some time aside this week and just ring a friend, or pray with them on the phone, or go and have a cup of tea with someone? Maybe people don't want you to know their problems and you could just leave a note for them or something. Greater love has no man. On this day, we think about all those years ago what happened in the trenches and on the war fields, and there were people like fighting Mac there with his shovel of all things. The Lord God laid down his life so that we would have freedom. And so we could actually sing when the billows are rolling, when we have sorrow, that we can sing this way. Would you sing with me just a few verses? If you feel like you want to come to the place of prayer and seek the peace of the Lord today, you need to just go and hear a whisper from the Lord today. The place of prayer is open. As we sing, thank you, Fiona. Jesus laid down his life for every one of us. For every one of us can know the gift of salvation. We can live in freedom and we can live in knowledge that one day we will meet with you. Amen. We will meet with you and we will not have any stains, but we will meet with you. Lord God, I pray for our church family this week. I pray, Lord God, where there is peace, thank you, Lord, where there is sorrow, I pray for comfort, I pray for compassion, I pray that there would be understanding. Where the billows are rolling, where it just feels like there's one thing after another, I pray for perseverance. I pray for endurance. I pray that we would be a church that comes alongside and says, let me help you. Father God, thank you for fighting Mac. Thank you for his great example of being so practical and just coming alongside and accepting people as they were. He had a religion that was attractive. And he had the Spirit of the Lord in his heart, the Spirit of the Lord and the Spirit of the Lord's word on his tongue. And we thank you for fighting that today. We just pray for those all around our country and across the ditch in New Zealand that will take time today to stop and reflect. And I thank you, Lord, for Major Brett and his team of chaplains across the nation who still today make cups of coffee and stand alongside and be the voice of compassion and understanding and silence. We need it where it's needed. So Lord, thank you for our time together this morning. Bless us, we pray, as we live to bless you this week. Amen and amen. We have got one final song. It's Raise a Hallelujah. Love this song. It talks a lot about, it's a really good ANZAC Day song actually. It's talks about the battle. As we sing it, I hope you'll engage with the lyrics. The words. Our friend Fighting Mac, big burly guy with a big voice, I'm sure he would have loved this song. And he would be up here with you, Carmen, singing out loud because he wants to raise a hallelujah. Would you stand as we sing together? Thank you.
Middle of the storm, la la la.
is a hallelujah.
But a word as you go out into this week, straight from our scripture today, words of Jesus. So this is my command. Love each other deeply, as much as I have loved you. Good morning. God bless you. Let's love deeply this week. The offering bags are at the door over here, and there's actually an offering bag at this door over here. Don't forget to leave the offering for the storehouse of the Lord, the Lord's Word. It's still going on. So don't forget your tithe or your offering this week. You might please, would you, do me a favour, just wipe down your chair and pop it on the one next to it. That would be really helpful for the housekeeping of the Lord's house. We're all about that. So good morning, God bless you, and I believe there's a tea and coffee on the